have a destiny. I know I shall fulfill. Somebody knows it. I have a destiny in that city on a hill. I have a destiny. It's not an empty wish, for I know I was born for such a time. Shall fulfill. Yeah, I have a destiny in that city on a hill. I have a destiny. It's not an empty wish, for I know I was born.
Shall we raise our hands to God? Ooh.
Magsisimula na po sa ating pag-aaral. At ay makakapagbukas po sa aklat ng Daniel, Book of Daniel. Tayo pong lahat ay makipagbukas. Let's open our Bibles in the Book of Daniel, chapter 10. Daniel, chapter 10. So if you have Bibles, you can follow me. But if you don't have Bibles, please listen intently. Okay, so our lesson for today is about the Book of Daniel. Medyo ito po ay teaching. This is gonna be a teaching. And sana po wag po kayong mabore because bagamat teaching po ito, ay meron po itong relevance lalo na sa mga mangyayari at magaganap in the last days. And actually, I plan to make a series of teaching on Book of Daniel. Gusto niyo po ba yun? Kasi ito na po yung mga prophetic visions ni Daniel na merong relevance and importance sa mga present day happenings, sa mga nangyayari ngayon. Okay, so the Book of Daniel, though it is an Old Testament book, it has an important significance to the present day because whatever happened in the Book of Daniel, the prophecies, the visions, and all the teachings in this prophetic book has a significant relevance in the present day modern history, especially so that I believe that we are in the last days. Okay, so I am going to talk about the Book of Daniel in the next few weeks, and I hope po na samahan niyo po ako. Huwag po kayong absent kasi po maganda po ito. I will try to make a presentation with matching PowerPoint at saka mga videos ng mga yung mga nangyayari ngayon in relation to the prophetic vision and prophecies of Daniel. Okay, so pero ngayon intro lang muna ito. Okay, so medyo hindi pa talaga ito teaching na teaching. Okay, are you ready?
Yeah.
Daniel chapter 10. I am reading from the Book of Daniel chapter 10 verse 1. In the third year of Cyrus, the king of Persia, a revelation was given to Daniel, who was also called Belteshazzar. Its message was true, and it concerned the great war. In other versions, it says the message was true, but the appointed time was too long, and he understood the message. In those days, I, Daniel, was mourning. 3 full weeks. I ate no pleasant food. No meat nor wine came into my mouth, nor did I anoint myself at all until the 3 whole weeks were fulfilled. On the 24th day of the first month, as I was standing on the bank of the great river of Tigris, I looked up, and there before me was a man dressed in linen, with a belt of the finest gold around his waist. His body was like chrysolite. His face was like lightning. His eyes like flaming torches. His arms and legs like the gleam of burnished bronze, and his voice like the sound of a multitude. I, Daniel, was the only one who saw this vision, and the man with me did not see it. But such terror overwhelmed them that they fled and hid themselves. So I was left alone, gazing at this great vision. I had no strength left. My face turned deathly pale, and I was helpless. And then I heard him speaking, and as I listened to him, I fell into a deep sleep, my face to the ground. Then a hand touched me and set me trembling on my hands and on my knees. He said, "Daniel, you who are highly esteemed, consider carefully the words I am about to speak to you, and stand up. For I have now been sent to you." And when he said this to me, I stood up trembling. And then he continued, "Do not be afraid, Daniel. Since the first day that you set your mind to gain understanding and you humbled yourself before your God, your words were heard. And I have come in response to them. But the prince of the Persian kingdom resisted me for 21 days. Then Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me because I was detained there with the king of Persia. Now I have come to explain to you what will happen to your people in the future, because this vision concerns a time yet to come." While he was saying this to me, I bowed my face towards the ground and was speechless. Then one who looked like a man touched my lips, and I opened my mouth and began to speak. I said to the one standing before me, "I am overcome with anguish because of the vision, my Lord, and I am helpless. How can I, your servant, talk with you, my Lord? My strength is gone, and I can hardly breathe." And again, the one who looked like a man touched me and gave me strength. "Do not be afraid, O man, highly esteemed," he said. "Peace be with you. Be strong. Be strong." When he spoke to me, I was strengthened, and I said, "Speak, my Lord, since you have given me strength." So he said, "Do you know why I have come to you? Soon I will return to fight against the prince of Persia, and when I go, the prince of Greece will come. But first I will tell you what is written in the book of truth. No one supports me against them except Michael, your prince." Okay, so ang buong chapter 10 of Daniel po ang ating pag-aaralan ngayon. The whole of chapter 10 is what we are going to study today. So we can see in the first part of this chapter, it says, in the third year of Cyrus, the king of Persia, Daniel was receiving a message, and he was having a vision. Sabi po doon, in the third year of Cyrus. Cyrus was the king of Persia during this time na ang mga Israelites have been returning to Babylon from exile. Because according to history, Babylon was the greatest empire during that time. But in the time of Daniel, at this point in time, Babylon was conquered by the Persian kingdom. And the king of Persian kingdom was Cyrus. And God, in his overwhelming sovereignty, allowed the Jews, allowed the Israelites to return to Jerusalem from their exile to Babylon. Nakuha mo ba natin? So nakita, di ba, ang mga Israelites ay yung kanila, ang Jerusalem was razed to the ground because of the emperors o yung mga Babylonians. So ang mga Israelita, nagpangalat sila. Sila ay nawala sa Jerusalem ng napakahabang panahon. Tapos makikita natin sa history nila, one time, these Israelites, by God's divine sovereignty and will, when the Persian kingdom emerged as a power, as a superpower in history, they were able to conquer Babylon. And Babylon was conquered. That was an impossible thing to happen, but it happened. Why? Because it has to happen. The Babylonians were to return to Jerusalem to rebuild the temple in the leadership of Ezra and Nehemiah. Iho ba? Alam po ba natin yon? So the Israelites were to return to Jerusalem to rebuild the temple under the leadership of Nehemiah and Ezra. But at this point of time, Daniel was saying he was mourning for 3 weeks. Okay? 3 weeks is equal to 21 days. Di ba? 3 weeks is equal to 21 days. And what was Daniel doing? He was mourning. He was in sorrow. Why? The Israelites were already returning to Babylon. Okay? They were already returning to Jerusalem from Babylon because Babylon was conquered by the Persian kingdom under the kingship and leadership of Cyrus. Now, why is Daniel mourning? Why is he in sorrow for 21 days? And not only that, he is in sorrow. He said he is also having no food, no meat, or wine into his mouth, nor did he anoint himself. So, we cannot say that Daniel was fasting during this time. Kasi, ang fasting is a deliberate declaration that you are abstaining from food, from meat, or anything. But Daniel was in self-denial because he was battling in prayer for this Jews to be able to safely go back to Jerusalem. Okay, so, and during this time, Daniel was already 84 years old. And he could not go back with them. And he deemed it necessary to stay in Babylon, under the Persian rule, because he will be more effective. Mas magiging effective siya pag nanatili siya sa Babylon, kasi meron siyang position doon. Meron siyang power doon sa Babylon. Kesa sumama siya doon sa mga Israelita kababayan niya na bumalik sa Jerusalem, mag-rebuild ng temple. So kanya-kanya silang trabaho. Dito na lang ako. Kasi dito may pwesto ako. May position ako. I have authority. And I can effectively help my kababayan. Ngayon, bahala na dyan si Ezra. Bahala na dyan si Nehemiah. Ang kanila namang toka, i-rebuild ang temple. Nakuha mo ba natin? And hindi siya nanatili. And he was mourning because hindi pa kompleto yung restoration. Hindi pa kompleto yung pagbabalik ng mga Israelita. Just a few portion of the population of the Israelites were able to go back. And he took it upon himself to take the responsibility to pray. Sabihin mo natin lahat, pray. To pray for the completion of the return of the exiles to Jerusalem. Hanggat hindi natatapos ang misyon, hanggat hindi natatapos ang pagbabalik ng mga Israelita, siya po ay nag-abstain sa food. He abstained from food. He denied himself from fleshly things, from the things that could give himself pleasure. Amen? It was self-denial. Ganun po tayo sa buhay natin, if we can apply this truth in our present lives, if we are searching for something, if we want something great, gusto natin ng isang bagay, gustong-gusto natin, hindi lang mo gugustuhin, kinakailangan gumawa ka ng paraan. Kagaya ni Daniel, he prayed intently, he prayed intensely, at hindi lamang siya nag-pray, kung kinakailangan niya, i-deny maraming bagay. Magsakripisyo. Amen? Gagawin niya. Marami po kasi sa atin, meron tayong gustong gusto. We want something so great, but we do not allow ourselves to sacrifice so great. If we want something, minsan, meron kapag meron tayong hinihingi sa Diyos, meron tayong kailangan bayaran. Amen? Meron tayong kailangan, we have to pay the price. And Daniel knew that exactly. And he said, this is not an easy task. Okay? The first step has been, you know, done by God. You know, by a stroke of faith and destiny and God's will, Babylonian kingdom was conquered. Amen? Nawala si Nebuchadnezzar. Everything, everything, because the Babylonians were the oppressors of the Israelites. They oppressed the Israelites. And God redeemed the Israelites, set them free. What? By what? By allowing the Persians to defeat the Babylonians so that the Israelites could be set free and they can go back to Jerusalem where they belong. That is their land of promise. Amen? That is their home. Amen? And being in Babylon, they have been oppressed. They have been in trouble. They have been in sorrow for such a long time. And came these Persians. Ang mga Persians, hindi po mga Kristiyano ito. Amen? Pero ginagamit ng Diyos kahit hindi mga Kristiyano para magawa ang kalooban niya. Amen? And the Persians defeated the Babylonians, the mighty Nebuchadnezzar. And so they were rejoicing. And there they go. They went back to Babylon, and they went back to Jerusalem. To what? Restore the temple. To restore Jerusalem. To rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Under Nehemiah and Ezra. Naunawaan ba natin yung picture? The greater picture? Okay. Now, let's go back to Daniel. Daniel, even though he could not go back with his kababayans, knew his responsibility. His responsibility was to pray. Samahan ko na lang kayo sa prayer. Samahan ko kayo sa prayer. What did he do? He abstained. He denied himself. He did not eat choice food. He did not taste wine. He did not anoint himself for 21 days intensely. He was praying. Amen po ba? Amen. And during this time, we can see that in that state of prayer and self-denial, he saw a vision. Sabi doon sa verse 4. Okay. Kung titignan po natin, if we will go back po na, sabi doon, gusto ko lang itong puntahan. Sabi niya, the message, verse 2, the message was true, but the appointed time was long. Okay? I want to point that out. The message is true. Sometimes, God's message to us is true because God is not a liar. Amen? Amen. But sometimes, the appointed time takes too long. Amen? Sabihin natin not too long. Too long. And sometimes, because it takes too long, some people are so impatient. They could not wait. And so they take matters into their own hands. It's either they take matters into their own hands or they give up because it's too long. I thought God promised me to be like this, to be like that, but it's taking too long and I am impatient. And so people take matters into their own hands or they simply give up. Sabihin natin lahat, give up. So sino tayo dito? Merong mga taong masyadong agresibo, hindi na nila mahintay ang Diyos, nagiging kagaya nila ni Sarah. Sarah knew that God promised Abraham and herself a son. And this son will give them offsprings as many as the sands of the sea, as many as the stars of the sky. But Abraham was already in his 90s, and so is Sarah in his 80s. Biologically speaking, it is impossible for them to give offspring. Biologically speaking, it is impossible for them to give birth. And so, what did Sarah do? He gave Hagar to Abraham. Sabi niya, ang tagal naman ng promise ng Diyos eh. Hagar, tabihan mo na nga yung anak asawa ko. I could not wait for God's promise. So Hagar is a concubine and and Sarah, the wife of Abraham, gave Hagar to Abraham so that the so-called promise of an offspring shall be fulfilled. And that's what happened. Okay? Abraham and Hagar gave birth to an offspring, and his name was Ishmael. And Ishmael was the firstborn of Hagar, of Abraham by Hagar. But Ishmael is not God's promised son. God's promised son is by Sarah. But Ishmael came first. And Ishmael is also claiming his birthright as an elder. Siya po yung panganay eh. And in God's appointed time, Abraham and Sarah gave birth to sino? Isaac. Isaac was God's promised son. But Ishmael came first. And so Ishmael persecuted Isaac. I am the firstborn son. Ako yun. Ako dapat. Amen? But Abraham knew in his heart that it is Isaac who is God's promised son. So, if we will look at history, Ishmael is the origin of the yung pong mga Middle Eastern people, yung mga Arabo, yung mga Muslim. Ishmael is the patriarch of the Muslims. Siya po yung naging pinagmulan ng lahing Muslim. Kaya nga po yung mga Muslim, tineterrorize nila hanggang ngayon, pinapersecute nila yung mga Israelites, yung mga Jews, na pinagmulan naman nila ay si Isaac. There is enmity between them. Hindi sila magkasundo hanggang ngayon, nagpapatayan sila. Until now, they kill each other. Amen? There is that enmity between them. And that is because of Sarah's impatience to wait for the perfect will and promise of God. Amen? Sometimes it takes too long before our prayers are answered. But that's not the reason for you to give up. That's not the reason for you to take matters into your own hand. Amen? It takes too long, but be like Daniel. Be persistent. Continue to pray intensely. 21 days, he was battling. He was having warfare. At kung titingnan natin, if we continue on, in verse 4, it says, because of his intense prayer, he saw a vision. Verse 4, on the 24th day of the first month, as I was standing on the bank of the great river, the Tigris, I looked up, and there before me was a man dressed in linen with a belt of the finest gold around his waist. His body was like chrysolite, his face like lightning, his eyes like flaming torches, his arms and legs like the gleam of burnished bronze, and his voice is like the sound of the multitude. Verse 7, I, Daniel, was the only one who saw this vision. The man with me did not see it, but such terror overwhelmed them that they had fled and hid themselves. So I was left alone, gazing at this great vision. I had no strength left. My face turned deathly pale and I was helpless. Then I heard him speaking, and as I listened to him, I fell into a deep sleep and faced myself to the ground. Makikita po natin dito na okay, Daniel had a vision. Ito pong vision na to ay parallel sa Revelation chapter 1, 12, 16. So many Bible scholars believe that it is a vision of Jesus. Okay, this is a vision of Jesus appearing in the Old Testament. Okay, sa Revelation chapter 1, 12, 16, ito po yung parallel niyan. Merong cloth with garment, girded with chest with a golden band, head and hair with white wool, eyes like a flame of fire, feet like fine brass, and voice as the sound of the many waters. So yan po yung parallel vision na yan. So commentators say that vision is Jesus in the Old Testament. Now, what happened to Daniel when he saw this vision? Ano pong nangyari sa kanya? Nanghina. Okay? Nanghina. He said, upon gazing at this great vision, I had no strength left, and I turned pale, and I was helpless. As godly as godly as Daniel is, he could not contain the glory of God. Daniel was a godly man, but he himself could not contain this glorious vision. How much more to the ungodly? Ano na lang mangyayari sa kanila? Patay agad sila. Amen? If you see this kind of vision, and if you don't have God in your heart, if you don't have Jesus in your heart, if you are not a Christian, you will instantly die. Daniel, as godly as he is, could not contain the godly vision of God in his, you know, sa harapan niya. Siya nga mismo, makadiyos na siya eh. Hindi niya kaya eh. Eh, paano na lang yung mga hindi makadiyos? Patay agad yun. Naunawalo ba natin? Amen? Si Daniel, abang nakikita niya itong vision na to, sobra yung kanyang pagka-overwhelm. He said, I have no strength. Amen? I am in deathly pale. Sabi niya ganun. Eh, makadiyos na to ah. Nagpa-fasting pa to. Hindi pa niya kaya yung glory ng Panginoon. Eh, paano na lang yung mga hindi Kristiyano? Amen? Pag nagpakita sa kanila yung glorious vision na ganito, wala na. Malalagutan na sila ng hininga. Amen? At yung mga kasama ni Daniel, he was the only one who was seeing this. The people who were with him could not see the vision, but still they felt the overwhelming presence of that glory. That, what did they do? They run and hid themselves. Amen? Tumakbo raw sila at nagtago. People, if they cannot take the heat of seeing the holiness of God, of hearing the holiness of God. Pag nagpipreach kasi tayo dito, hindi tayo patumpik-tumpik eh. Amen? Sinasabi talaga natin diretsahan. We tell directly what sin is. Amen? We don't baby people. We don't say, oh, it's okay na maging ganito pa. Oh, it's okay to drink alcohol on occasions. It's okay to smoke marijuana on occasions as long as you don't go overdo it. Amen? We don't do that. We tell directly what sin is. And if people could not take the heat, amen, of being preached upon with sin, and so what do? They run and hit themselves and never come back. Diba? Pag tayo nangangaral, kapag if we preach the truth, and the truth hurts, the truth strikes us right to the core of our soul, because we are doing things that are against the will of God, people will say, hindi na ako babalik dyan. Grabe. Ginahalo ka yung puso ko. Bakit tinichismis mo ba ako dun sa pastor mo? Bakit niya alam yung buhay ko? Tinichismis mo ba ako dyan kay sister? Do you squeal my life to your pastor? Why does he know me? Why does he know my heart? Why does he know my life? But the truth is, wala pong alam si pastor sa buhay mo. Pero kilala ka ng Diyos. The pastor doesn't know anything about you, but God knows you right to your core. Amen? Right to the tiniest of the cells of your body. God knows the counts of the cells of your body, the count of your hair. From inside and outside, God knows you so well. Amen? And so if a person that is anointed by God stands up here and preaches, and sakulin ka ng preaching, hindi dahil kilala ka ng pastor o dahil gusto kang saktan ng pastor, kundi dahil ang Diyos kilala ka at nais ka niyang baguhin. Sige po, palakpakan natin ang Panginoon. It is not that because the pastor wants to hurt you and is delivering a powerful preaching that is, you know, striking you right into your very soul. It's not because God hates you, it's not because the brethren hates you, but it's because God loves you so much that He wants to change you. He wants to let you realize who you are in His presence. And that's what Daniel had. Amen? As godly as he is already. Amen? Sometimes God, when He makes His presence felt in our lives, it's either we could not contain it. Hindi natin kaya. Grabe yung glory ng Panginoon, di ba? And so, because we could not contain it, we react in different manners. Sometimes for me, I am overwhelmed with God's presence, I just cry. Umiiyak lang ako, kahit nandun ako sa FX, kahit nasa jeep ako, kahit nasaan ako, I just cry. Habang binabasa ko itong Daniel 10, umiiyak ako kaninang umaga. Sabi ko, Lord, grabe, yung glory mo, your glory is overwhelming. That just like Daniel, people could not contain. People could not, do not know how to deal with God. And so if, you know, some people, they run and hide. And for Daniel, he lost his strength. Nalalabot na siya, di ba? Pumisa ganun tayo, di ba? Para tayong lutang. Para tayong lutang pag galing na tayo sa presence ng Panginoon. Physically, we are drained. But emotionally and spiritually, we are strengthened. Because we just had an encounter with God. Amen? We just had an encounter with God. So it is possible to have an encounter with God. Amen? Just like what Daniel experienced in Daniel chapter 10. And so many of us have so many different kinds of encounters. Amen? And if you could not enumerate any encounter with God in your life, then you are lacking greatly, brethren. Pag wala kang masabing encounter mo sa Diyos sa buong panahon ng pagka-Kristiyano mo, abay, ang dami mong namimiss, kapatid. Amen? Dapat sa tagal mo ng Kristiyano, meron kang masabing encounter mo sa Panginoon, kagaya ng Daniel chapter 10 encounter. Amen? Dapat masabi mong, grabe, sa prayer ko kanina, humahagulgul ako, naglulupasay ako. Nawala ako sa sarili ko, tapagkat dinalaw ako ng Panginoon. Amen? Have you ever experienced God's visitation? You should if you are a Christian. Because God loves to let His presence be felt by His people. Amen? He inhabits the praises of His people, the book of Psalms says. And so people say, you are crazy. Because you say, you talk to God. You feel God. You experience God. You see God. Amen? They say and accuse us we are crazy. But it's true. Just like Daniel. He had this vision. And it is a glorious vision. What did he see? It is a man clothed in white linen, belted with gold. Amen? Ano pang sabi doon? His head and hair were white like wool, and his eyes were flaming like fire, and his feet were like fine as brass, and his voice was like the voice of a multitude. It was thundering. Amen. This is just one of those many visions that, you know, the Bible tells about your encounter with God. And in this vision, how did his companions, how did Daniel's companions reacted? They run and hid because they could not contain the glory of God. If you are harboring sin in your heart and God's holiness come in your midst, you could not contain. Parang sinisilihan. It's like you're roasted in fire. Parang inaano. Iniihaw. Parang feeling mo na sa impyerno ka na. It's like a hell experience. Because the holiness of God is convicting you. And that sin in your heart just couldn't be dealt with. Hindi mo kaya. Ang ginagawa ko, tumatakbo ka, nagtatago ka. Amen? But at for Daniel naman, as godly as he is, physically he was drained. That's how powerful the encounter was. That's how powerful the experience was. But in the end, makikita po natin. Okay, let's see. Ituloy po natin. And then, verse 10, a hand touched me and set me trembling on my hands and knees. So, he fainted. Nawala siya ng malay. Okay? He was into deep sleep. A hand touched me and set me trembling on my hands and my knees. He said, Daniel, you who are highly esteemed. Sa ibang okay, in other version, Okay, sabi po doon na, you who are highly esteemed, consider carefully the words I am about to speak to you when stand up. For I have now been sent to you, and when he said this to me, I stood up trembling. Then he continued, do not be afraid, Daniel. Since the first day that you set your mind to gain understanding and humbled yourself before your God, your words were heard, and I have come in response to them. But the prince of Persian kingdom resisted me 21 days. Okay? May dumating. So, he was in deep sleep. He fainted. He could not contain the glory of God. And then somebody woke him up and somebody touched his lips and said, Daniel, wake up. I have come to give you the message. And the message was, you are highly esteemed. Okay? Ang ibig sabihin po ng highly esteemed, you are highly favored. Amen? You are highly favored. Ang ibig sabihin, the favor of God is upon you. God is looking upon you. You are special in the sight of God. Okay? Did you ever realize that you are special in the sight of God? You look down on yourself too much. You have self-pity. You have insecurities. I don't know what you've been through in life. But you look down yourself too much that you cannot even believe that you can do great things. Amen? But Daniel is saying, Daniel, you are highly esteemed. Daniel, you are highly favored. Daniel, you are special in the sight of God. That the moment you opened your mouth to pray, God heard your prayers. Amen? Noong una pa lang daw na binuka ni Daniel, yung panalangin sa bibig niya, narinig na ng Diyos. The first time you, minsan nga hindi mo pa binubuka eh. Nandun pa lang, naglalaro pa lang sa isip mo, alam na lang Diyos, narinig na niya, di ba? And the Lord is saying, the first time you ever opened your mouth in prayer, God heard it. Amen? Because what? You are special in His sight. If you are special and He is your Father, how can He ever resist you? Tayo nga, we are earthly parents eh. And if our kids come to us and say, maglambing, bilang mo naman ako ng Nike. Kahit 10,000, bibilin mo, di ba? Kasi mahal mo yung anak mo. Hindi mo kaya tanggihan. Amen? Gagawin mo ang lahat para mabigyan sila ng pabor. You love, we love our children so much that whatever they ask of us, we give them. Because we love them. We favor them. We esteem them. And so with God, the first time that you opened your mouth, saith this man, I heard, God heard you. But what happened? Bakit? Ano nangyari? Tingnan po natin. Nangyari. Okay. Okay. So, we are seeing here that whenever we pray, it is said that God is deaf, that He could not hear our prayers. God responded to Daniel's prayer the moment he made his request known. Because Daniel had been in great and serious prayer for 3 weeks. He was even abstaining himself from fleshly things like choice food and wine and anointment. But why is Daniel not receiving the answer to his prayers? And it's taking too long. Why? Ito po yung sagot. Okay. Since the first day, verse 12, that you set your mind, God heard your words. And I have come in response to them. Ako na nga yung mag-deliver. I am the one who will deliver the answer to your prayers. But, eto yun. Verse 13. The prince of Persia resisted me for 21 days. And then Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me. Prince of Persia. Sabihin na natin lahat, Prince of Persia. Prince of Persia here stands for the demonic forces that try to stop the plan and the will of God in our lives. This man in Daniel's vision is saying, you know what? The moment you opened your mouth, to ask God something in prayer. God heard you. Mm-hmm. And I was already there on delivery. I-deliver ko na eh. Papunta na ako eh. Papunta na ako, i-deliver ko na yung answer sa prayer. I am going to deliver, you know, on a silver platter, the answers to prayers. But, eto ang pinaka malaking but. Verse 13, the prince of Persia came and resisted me. So, mga kapatid, Christianity is not a walk in the park. Parang hindi ka namamasyal sa luneta ng walang pera. Amen? Ang Christianismo ay isang giyera. Amen? Christianity is war. Just as Christianity is a promised good life, Christianity and true Christianity is war. Amen? And that's where many Christians fail. Because they never realize that Christianity is war. And they never realize that when they pray, things do not come easily because there are demonic forces that try to hinder the delivery of God's answer to our prayers. Dito po malinaw na malinaw yan. Sabi ganun, papunta na ako, sabi nitong man sa vision ng Panginoon ni Daniel eh. Kaya alam, dumating yung Prince of Persia. Okay? Ang Prince of Persia ay yung mga matataas ang rangko. Because if there is a God's kingdom, there is a devil's kingdom. And in the devil's kingdom, there is also a hierarchy. May mga rangko rin yung mga demonyo. Merong mga general, merong mga major, captain, at saka mga ordinaryong mga demonyo lang. Eh yung Prince of Persia, medyo mataas ang rango nun. Yun ang umarang sa prayer ni Daniel. Kasi yung pinapag-pray ni Daniel, restoration of Jerusalem. Amen? Restoration of worship, restoration of temple, will of God. Kaya pag will of God, hinaharang ng demonyo. When you are praying for God's will, you should realize that it is not easy. You have to fight for it. You have to battle for it. It is a war. Amen? And that is what is this teaching is making us realize. And so, ma-realize nyo, kaya kapag naiinip kayo, huwag kayong mainip. Kasi, ibig sabihin nun, parang si Daniel lang, ituloy mo lang, makipagbuno ka, makipaglaban ka. Amen? Makipagpatayan ka at makipaghabulan sa mga demonyo. Kung pwede. Now, if we are saying that Christianity is warfare, okay? You do not go to war without being equipped. Amen? You do not go to war without being trained. You do not go to war without having your mga weapons. Amen? And maraming mga Kristiyano, they go to war without being equipped, without weapons. So, nangyayari, namamatay sila. Patay. Kagad. Amen? Kaya nga po dito pumapasok ang discipleship. Dito pumapasok ang matinding pukpukan, ang matinding basagan, ang matinding character. Melting, molding. Amen? And shaping. Dito pumapasok yon. Amen? Because God wants to equip you. God wants to strengthen you. God wants to send you there knowing what you're doing. Otherwise, baka mapana ka lang, patay ka agad. Amen? Unang araw pa lang ng pagsabak mo sa misyon, umiiyak ka na. Kasi naka-encounter ka ng lasing na halos kainin ka ng buhay. Amen? Nung nag-evangelize kami sa Makati doon sa Riles, lahat yata ng mga halang ng kaluluwa, pugad yun. Amen? So, pag nag-evangelize kami doon, puro kami mga babae. Amen? So, akala namin, pag mga babae, hindi nila babastusin. Hindi nila papatusin. Hindi nila papatulan. Ay, wala silang sinisino. Kahit mga babae kami, saka maaayos ang mga damit namin, mga gamit, paglasing, wala eh. So, nakakatakot. Maraming mga dangers. Maraming mga pagtatangka sa buhay. Pero, dahil alam namin, kasama namin ang Panginoon and we've been through training, grabe yung discipleship, mga unang panahon, alam nyo yan. And we have been ready for it kasi alam namin, na Christianity is a warfare. Eh. Naranasan namin nakikipaghabulan sa mga demonyo. Literally. Amen? Nakikipagbuno sa mga diablo at mga demonyo. Nakikipaghabulan. As in, nakikipaghabulan kasi nakikita namin sila with our eyes. Amen? And it is a spiritual warfare. Sabihin mo na nila, spiritual warfare. Ngayon, you cannot go to spiritual warfare kung hindi ka nagpa-fasting. You cannot go to spiritual warfare kung hindi ka equipped. You cannot go to spiritual warfare if you are not strong and matapang. Amen? Kung iyakin ka, naku, wala. Walang mangyayari sa'yo. Amen? Magmumuy-muy ka na lang. Amen? Kaya, Christianity is not for the faint of heart. Christianity is not for the weak in heart. Because Christianity is war. Amen? Kagaya ng sinasabi dito. Sabi ni nung man in the vision to me, you know what? I was sent by God to deliver the answers to your prayers. But somewhere, the prince of Persia resisted me. And I had to battle for 21 days. Sabi ng man in vision. I had to battle for 21 days. So, in the spiritual realm, there is a war going on. Between this, si Michael, nagpadala raw ang Diyos si Michael. Sino si Michael? Michael the Archangel. Amen? Siya yung anghel ng Panginoon. Michael the Archangel. Si Gabriel, siya yung mensahero ng Panginoon nung pinanganak si Jesus. Si Mary, messenger lang siya. Pero si Michael, siya po yung ano? Warrior. Amen? Nakikipaglaban, nakikipagdigma. Siya yung anghel ng mga mandirigma. Kaya kung kinakailangan mo ng tulong, tawagan mo si Michael the Archangel para ipaglaban ka. Amen? Darating siya. Sapagkat siya ang isinugo ng Panginoon na tagapagtanggol natin. Siya si Michael the Archangel. At doon sa ating binasa, Michael came to rescue. Amen? At naglalaban si Michael the Archangel doon versus, na-imagine nyo ba? Hindi animation to ha, hindi anime to ha. Hindi parang Naruto to, Dragon Ball ha. Totoo to. Daniel chapter 10. Nangyayari doon sa spiritual realm, naglalaban si Michael the Archangel and the Prince of Persia. Habang dito naman sa lupa, si Daniel, 21 days, nakikipagbuno sa laman niya. Amen? Nakikipagbuno, pinapatay niya yung sarili niya. At nananalangin. Sabihin mo natin lahat, nananalangin. So, it is simultaneously happening. Habang may nangyayari sa spiritual realm, sabayan mo rin ng panalangin dito. Huwag kang tutulog-tulog. Amen? Kinakailangan mong panalangin. Meron ka bang hinihingi sa Diyos? Hanggang ngayon, hindi mo pa rin makamit-kamit. Meron ka bang pinapanalangin sa Diyos? Do you have a prayer in your heart? It is a long time prayer that it has not come for such a long time that you become impatient already. Then realize this. It might be like this situation. That the answer to the prayers is on the way. But you have to battle more. You have to fight for it more. Amen? Don't, wag kayong bibitaw sa prayer. Amen? Don't give up in prayer, just like Daniel did. Amen po ba? Amen? Amen. Naunawaan mo ba natin? Amen. Okay, so yun. Meron ka bang pinapanalangin? Baka kinakailangan mong dagdagan ng intense prayer kagaya po ng ginagawa ni Daniel. Okay, tuloy po natin. So the prince of the kingdom of Persia came by to resist. And so, sabi po doon, okay, sabi po ng man in the vision, the angel was dispatched because of Daniel's prayer. So this is another reminder that in the book of Daniel, that prayer matters. It is not merely a therapeutic exercise. Sometimes hindi lang yun, Lord, bless me, bless my mother, bless my father, bless my angkan, bless me, bless me, bless me. Hindi lang po ganun ang prayer. Amen? Lord, give me this, give me that, give me this, give me that. Sometimes, it is a spiritual battle. And you have to pray like never before. Amen? It is an intense prayer, which means it is a warfare. And sabi ko kanina, you have You have to be equipped to do that. Ephesians, ano po yun? Sa Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12, makikita po natin ito yung mga things that will equip us in battling, okay, the spiritual forces in the heavenly realms. Sabi doon, the armor of God. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in His mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. Because our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers. Who are these? The demonic forces. Against the powers of the dark world. And against the spiritual forces of evil in heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God so that on the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after that, you have done everything, stand firm. Eto na, belt of truth. Okay, you should be living in the word of truth of God. And then, put on the breastplate of righteousness. Breastplate of righteousness. What is that? The holiness of God. Don't live in sin. Live a righteous life. Abandon sin. Give up sin. Surrender your sins to God. Because otherwise, you cannot withstand the forces of the evil one. Next, put on your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. Your feet thou should be having that readiness to preach the gospel of peace. You should be a missionary. You should go out. Humayo. Amen. Evangelize. Win souls for Christ. That is one weapon that you can have. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith. Shield. What kind of shield? Faith. Amen. What is faith? Faith is believing in things that you have not seen. But still, you believe. You hang on. Amen. Sometimes, it's very difficult. Sabi nila, kayo mga Kristiyano, naniniwala kayo sa Diyos. Hindi naman nakikita ang Diyos. Why do you believe in God? You haven't even seen God. Amen? That's the most, million-dollar question. But that is faith. Faith is believing. Hebrews 11:1 is having faith. Said in the Bible, yes, faith is having belief in something that you have not seen. But still, you cling on to it. That is faith. Otherwise, it's not faith. Okay? So, yun ang sinasabi. You need that in order for you to be able to withstand the evil one. Shield of faith. Next, extinguish all the flaming arrows. Ayan, yan ang mag-extinguish ng flaming arrows of the evil one. So, kapag tayo pinapana ng diablo ng mga kasinungalingan niya, faith ang pag-shield natin. Amen? If you have great faith, all of those arrows will be extinguished. Amen? Patay lahat yun, mawawala ng bisa. Next, take on the helmet of salvation. Helmet. Can you imagine? Parang yung mga old warriors, helmet. May helmet ka raw. What helmet? Helmet of salvation. So you should be born again. You cannot fight the evil one unless you are born again. You should be saved. The Bible says, believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved. How can you have salvation? You have to have religion. Do you need to have doctrine? Do you need to be a part of an organization? No. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved. You just have to believe in Jesus Christ. Hindi pala mahirap, di ba? Salvation is a free gift from God. You just have to accept it. Okay, so helmet of salvation. Next, what next? Ano pa po yung weapon natin? Okay. Sword of the Spirit. You need to have a sword. And what is that sword of the Spirit? It is the Word of God. And that is the importance of reading the Bible every day. If you're a Christian, you need to read your Bible every day because it is your sword. Amen? And the sword needs to be sharpened. Otherwise, hindi makakapatay. A sword could be dull and rusty if you are not using it. But if you are using it, it will be sharp and deadly. Amen. And that is the Word of God. That's the importance of the Word of God. That's why, mga Kristiyano, you are not a Christian if you are not reading the Word of God. Hello? Amen. We get too busy on a lot of things. Ang dami natin pinagkakabisihan. Busy-busyhan. But we need to be busy on one thing. We need to be busy on the Word of God. Yes, it's good to earn livelihood. You need that. Praise God. But more so, you need the Word of God in your life. Amen. Man shall not live by bread alone, Matthew 4:4. But by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Man shall not live by bread alone. Bread here is symbolic of our resources, of our livelihood, that we think is what we need in order to survive. But the Bible says, no, Matthew 4:4 is very clear on this. You cannot live on bread alone. You cannot live on your money, on your bank account, on your wealth, on your resources, but by every word that comes out of the mouth of God. Yeah. And so people are so weak on dealing with the pressures of life because they don't have the Word of God. They kill themselves. Japanese, if they are so depressed, they're so wealthy, they're so progressive, they're so economically blessed. But why is it that Japan has the highest of the suicide rate, one of the highest of the suicide rate in the world? They have stable jobs. They have big houses. They have the best of cars. Amen? Toyota, Nissan, nasa kanila yung lahat. Mitsubishi, Suzuki, Isuzu. Amen? They have the greatest economy. One of the greatest economies in the world. But Japanese people are the most lonely people, the most sorrowful people, that if the sorrow overwhelms them, they kill themselves. Why? Because they have all the wealth in the world, but they don't have the Word of God. Yeah. And so they are the most pitiful persons in the world. Sila pinakawawa. They are the most pitiful people in the world, despite their economy, despite their wealth, despite their technology, despite everything that they can boast about. They are the most pitiful and most lonely people in the world because they don't have the Word of God. When you talk Jesus about them, when you talk about God to them, they say, what? Who is Jesus? Who is God? What is salvation? They don't know anything. They don't know anything about what is the most important thing in life. But we are so blessed because we are not rich. We might not be economically stable. We might not be wealthy. But we have the Word of God. Amen. Amen. We have the Word of God, and the word of God says that's what you need. The sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God, because it is the Word of God that will defeat the evil forces of this world. Okay? If the devil says you're going to die, you have cancer, amen? Sasabihin ng demonyo sa yan, meron kang bukol, meron kang sis, amen? And that will never go away. And the Word of God says, I have sent my word and healed your disease. Amen? Exodus 15:26. Amen? And the Bible says, there is no power that is above every name. And that is the name of Jesus. Wala rin ibang power na mas tataas pa sa power ng pangalan ng Panginoong Jesus. And that is the name of Jesus. At meron tayo nun, di ba? Amen? Di ba kayo na-excite? Kasi meron tayong Jesus, sila wala. Amen. And if we have Jesus, everything is possible. Because there is no power that is above every name, but the name of Jesus. And the Bible says, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, and every tongue confess that He is Lord, even Satan and his demon cohorts in hell. When you say the name of Jesus, the devil flees. The demons flee. Amen? And people don't realize that. If they are sick, they are depressed. They're depressed sila. Mamatay na ako. I will die. But the Word of God is powerful and it says, I have healed you by the stripes of Jesus. Amen? Isaiah 54, by the stripes of Jesus, you are healed. Sa mga latay ni Jesus, tayo gumaling na. Amen? Kaya kailangan natin po ang salita ng Diyos. Amen? We need the Word of God. It is the sword of the Spirit that is one of our weapons. So can you imagine? Are you complete now? Amen? Your weapon, shield of faith, breastplate of righteousness, amen, helmet of salvation, sword of the Spirit, the feet that is clothed with the gospel of peace, amen, to be a missionary to the world, to win souls for Christ, amen. So what else? Ano pa yung kailangan natin na weapon? Sa kung babasahin po natin ang Ephesians, ay kung tutuloy-tuloy po natin yan, ay andyan po lahat ng kailangan natin. Amen po ba? Okay, nililipad. Ephesians 6, ituloy po natin yung ating binabasa. Tapos na tayo sa sword of faith, and then, sabi ganon, this is the word of God. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions, with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert, and always keep on praying for all the saints. So pray. After that, if you realize that you have the weapons of warfare in your life, then you pray. And then you are well equipped. Amen po ba? Amen. So many Christians seem to be defeated because what? They are not equipped with the weapons of warfare. They don't have the shield of faith. And so when the devil and his demon cohort darts arrows upon them, shoot agad, patay. Pero hindi dapat eh. Dapat tayo yung pumapatay ng demonyo, hindi tayo yung pinapatay ng demonyo. Naunawano ba natin? Bakit? Eh kasi kulang siya ng weapon eh. Wala siyang breastplate. Wala siyang shield. Wala siyang helmet. Pero yung ang mga soldiers sa unang panahon, they have to be equipped with all these weapons. Otherwise, they will die in the battlefield. And that is same. That is true. With us Christians, we are in war. It's not a walk in the park. Wala po tayo sa parke. Wala po tayo sa mall. We are in war. And we are at war with the devil and his demon cohorts. And so, because you realize that you are in war, you equip yourself. Amen? You shield yourself. Put on the armor of God. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 10 to 12. Amen? The helmet of salvation, the shield of faith, the breastplate of righteousness, the sword of the Spirit, the gospel of peace in your feet. Amen? And so, if you feel that you are equipped, matapang ka. Kasi alam mo, di ba? Kompleto ka. Sa protection. Parang siling. Amen? But if you know that you are not equipped, you hesitate to go to war. You hesitate to go to battle. You don't, hindi mo kayang sabihin sa diablo, diablo, talo ka! Hindi. Pag alam mo na ikaw ay equipped, demonyo ka, lumayas ka sa buhay ko, sa pamilya ko, sa asawa ko, sa anak ko! Amen? You know your authority. And the Bible says, at the name of Jesus, you shall bow, devil. At the name of Jesus, you and your demon cohort shall bow. And I command you to flee in my life, in my family, in my loved ones, in my nation, and in whatever concerns you have. Amen? You know your authority, and that is the name of Jesus. Amen. Yeah, kaya minsan di po natin ito nare-realize eh. And we allow ourselves to be defeated. And that is not the will of God. Kaya doon sa babalikan natin yung book of Daniel, ganun po yung nangyari. There is a war. And the plan of God, the will of God, was stopped doon pa lang sa heavenly realms. Pero praise God, dumating si Michael the Archangel. And Michael the Archangel fought with the prince of Persia. And sometimes, if you think that you are not strong enough, God's help is on the way. Amen? And you just have to humble yourself. Sabi dito sa kung titingnan natin, sabi sa ating binasa, sabi po doon sa book of Daniel, sabi yung ganun, you know what? Sabi yung ganun, the moment you opened your mouth and humbled yourself before God, that is one of the characteristics of Daniel. He is a humble man. Amen? He humbled, nagpatirapa siya sa harapan ng Diyos. He is a humble man. And humility is one of the most difficult, amen, characteristics that people can have. Kasi ang daling magyaba, ang daling lumaki ang ulo, ang daling sabihin, kaya-kaya ko yan. Amen? Pero si Daniel po, he humbled himself before God. And that's what God wants from us. to humble ourselves and admit that, Lord, apart from you, I am nothing. John chapter 15. Amen. You are the vine and I am just the branch. And if this branch is pulled away from you as the vine, I cannot do anything. I can be unproductive. I am unfruitful. I am useless. I am nothing. But if we humble ourselves before God and say, Lord, I need you. Hindi ko na po kaya. And then help will come. But as long as you say, kaya ko to, I can do this. Amen? Pero alam mo naman hindi mo na kaya, hindi darating ang tulong. Pero pag sinabi mo, Lord, hindi ko na talaga kaya eh. Ikaw na, take over. And then help will come. And then Michael the Archangel will come. Amen? And then Michael the Archangel will fight for you. And then Michael the Archangel will defeat the enemy for you. And then Michael the Archangel will bring victory to you. And that's what exactly happened in Daniel chapter 10. Amen? Kung babasahin po natin at itutuloy natin, sabi po ng man in the vision, then Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me because I was detained with the king of Persia. Biro mo, dinetain daw siya ng king of Persia. Ibig sabihin, nagapi itong man of vision na to. But now I have got to explain to you what will happen to your people in the future for the visions of concerns a time yet to come. What is this? The devil is trying to stop the answers to the prayers of Daniel because it is the will of God. It is the prophetic vision that Daniel will see in Daniel 11, in Daniel 12. Yung mga prophetic visions na nakita niya sa Daniel chapter 11 at Daniel chapter 12 na mangyayari sa bayan ng Israel at sa buong mundo sa huling kapanahunang ito. These are the prophetic visions that will happen in the last of the last days of the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why the devil is trying everything in his power to stop it, so that the people of God will be clueless about the will of God. Para hindi nila alam kung anong plano ng Diyos. At yun ang pinakamahirap, pag hindi mo alam ang plano ng Diyos sa buhay mo. Amen? If you don't know the will of God in your life, the plan of God in your life, that's the most difficult thing. Because you don't have direction. Sabi nga yung kanta, ang buhay mo raw ay parang ano, hangin na walang patutunguhan. Amen? No direction. And that's what the devil wants. For you to be clueless on the will of God in your life. Para you waste your time. Parang marami kang sayangin oras. Marami kang sayangin resources. Marami kang sayangin mga bagay-bagay sa buhay mo. Kasi hindi mo alam ang plano ng Diyos sa buhay mo. But once you know the will of God, bullseye ka agad. Yun, meron ka ng blueprint, meron ka ng sinusundan, meron ka ng, alam mo na kung anong gagawin mo. And, wala kang sasayangin oras, wala kang sasayangin panahon. Naunawaan mo ba natin? Amen? Okay, so, yun po yung inaharang ng Diablo. The devil is trying to stop the vision to come to Daniel so that the vision and the prophecies will not be revealed. Amen? But God will not allow that. Amen? So he sent Michael. Ganun din po sa buhay natin. If the will of God is slowly being revealed in our lives, nakikita na natin, nagiging malinaw na. Gagawa ang Diablo para alabuin yun. Para hindi natin makita kung ano yung plano ng Diyos sa buhay natin. Amen? Because the devil doesn't want the will of God to happen in our lives. But God will not allow it. Magpapadala po siya ng tutulong. Amen? And dito po sa ating binasa, it was Michael the Archangel who fought for that vision to come. Amen? And so he did. Okay, tuloy po natin. Verse 15, while he was saying this to me, Daniel was speaking, I bowed my face to the ground and was speechless. And then one who looked like a man touched my lips and opened my mouth and began to speak. I said to the one standing before me, I am overcome with anguish because of the vision, my Lord. Hallelujah! Nakita na niya ang vision. Amen? Daniel is, you know, looking right in front of his eyes. All the visions unfolding. Amen. The prophecies of the last days, the events of the last days, it's happening. The vision is being seen by Daniel. Why? Because Michael the archangel was victorious. Nanalo si Michael, the archangel, and the vision came. Ano sabi ni Daniel? The vision came. The vision came. Then I said to the one standing before me, I am in anguish because of the vision, my Lord, and I am helpless. How can I, your servant, talk with you, my Lord? My strength in God is gone, and still I can hardly breathe. So physically speaking, Daniel was just overwhelmed. But again, the one who looked like a man touched me and gave me strength. Amen? And do not be afraid, O man, O highly esteemed and highly favored. He said, peace be unto you, be strong. Sometimes, while waiting for God's will to happen in our lives, we become faint. We give up. We tend to be, nangihina na tayo, and we said, guntong hininga na lang. Amen? But just as the perfect time, when you feel like giving up, God will come and say, be strong, my child. Kaya mo yan. Kalapitin mo yung katabi mo, kaya mo yan. Mas malakas, kaya mo yan. Isa pa, yugyugin mo, kaya mo yan. Sabi mo, don't give up. Amen. And so, Daniel experiences. Sabi niya, hindi ko na yata kaya, 21 days na ako. 21 days na ako nakikipagbuno. Alam niyo po, baka magkatapos ng spiritual warfare, pakikipag-warfare, grabe, parang pinamawisan ka na naglalambot, di ba? Sino dito yung mga warrior? Di ba nanay Cora? Pagkatapos ng 21 days fasting, di ba nanay Cora? Mahina ka physically. Totoo yan. Physically mahina ka, pero spiritually, malakas ka. Pero nabubuhay ka pa rin sa physical eh, kaya nakakaramdam ka. Minsan akala mo, parang nanghihina ka na. Pero, sa mga pagkakataong ganun, dumarating ang Diyos at sasabi, anak, you are highly favored. Be strong. Peace, be strong. Hindi lang be strong, may peace pa. Kasi kung minsan, hindi yung physical battle ang mahirap eh. Yung mental battle, yung, kasi ito yung playground ni Satan minsan eh. We allow Satan to play in our minds by giving us deceit, by giving us lies and deception. At yun ang pinakamahirap, yun ang pinakamalaking struggle. When we are lied upon by the devil saying, oh, ganito ka, ganyan ka, ganito ang nangyayari sa pamilya mo, ganito, ganyan, ganyan, wala ka ng pag-asa, and all the lies. Amen? That's the most difficult thing. But the Lord is saying, peace. Peace, my child. Pumayapa ka. Kalma lang. Amen? Kalma lang, kapatid. Amen? Huwag mo isipin mamamatay ka na. Hindi ka mamamatay. Mararapture ka. Eh, ganito kasi ang nararamdaman ko eh. Nararamdaman mo yan, pero hindi yan ang sinasabi ng salita ng Diyos. Peace, be strong. Amen? Peace, be strong. Kompleto, di ba? Pinapapayapa ka sa isip mo, pinapalakas ka sa physical mo. Ang buti ng Lord, no? Ano pang mahihilig mo? Ano pang hahanapin mo? God completely ministers to us. And that's what He did with Daniel. And so, we will find out in the next series po ng Daniel na ito na, we will find out that the visions that God gave Daniel are significant and relevant for us to understand the happenings of these last days. Kung hindi dumating yung vision na yun, wala itong mga prophecies. Hindi natin malalaman kung ano yung kalooban ng Diyos. Buti na lang, hindi sumuko si Daniel. 21 days nakipagbuno siya. 21 days nakipag-warfare siya. 21 days, hindi siya sumuko. Hindi siya nag-give up. After 21 days, dumating ang prayer niya. Kaya significant yung 21 days fasting, 40 days fasting. Kay Moses naman yun, 3 days fasting. Doon kay Jesus. So makikita po natin na ang prayer ay hindi lang sapat na mag-pray ka, kundi ipaglaban mo ito. Sapagkat hindi ito simpleng humingi ka lamang. Minsan, andyan ang diablo para harangin ang sagot sa panalangin mo. Amen? Amen. So, meron po ba tayong natutunan sa buhay ni Daniel sa chapter 10? Okay? Simple lang ang nais kong iparating sa inyo. Tayo ay favored ng Panginoon. We are favored by the Lord. We are highly esteemed by the Lord. And the moment we opened our mouth to pray to God, God heard our prayers. But the prince of Persia will try to resist and stop the prayer's answer. Amen? And so what will you do? Like Daniel, here on earth, you battle it out. Amen? Put on your shield. Put on your helmet. Put on your breastplate. Take up your sword. Amen? And be equipped and be ready to battle it out with the demon forces of hell. And the promise of God is that the name of Jesus shall be upon you. Kasama mo ang pangalan ni Jesus. At ang pangalan ni Jesus ang pinakamalakas sa lahat ng pangalan na ang mga demonyo at ang diablo ay luluhod. Amen? Luluhod! Magpapatira pa sila sa pangalan ni Jesus. Yan ang dapat nare-realize natin. Eh, ang kaso, hindi po natin ito na-realize. And so, we allow ourselves to be defeated and losers. But the fact is, God has planned for us to be victorious. Everything He has provided for us. The weapons of warfare. And the name that is above every name. That is Jesus. Amen? Amen. So, kapag dumating ang mga bagay na ito sa buhay natin, yun po ang alalahanin natin. And so kung ito, kung ito, tuloy ko po ito ang sabi po doon sa sabi nga ni do not be afraid, verse 19, O man, highly esteemed, peace be upon you, be strong now, be strong. And the Lord is saying to you, peace and be strong. And so when He spoke to me, I was strengthened. Amen? Siya po ay lumakas. Amen? So kung kailangan mo ng lakas, ang Diyos pwede kanyang palakasin. Palalakasin kanya. Kalooban niya yan. And so he said, speak my Lord, since you have given me strength. And Daniel was restored. And he was strengthened. And now he is ready. Amen? Now he is ready to receive all the promises, all the prophecies, all the visions. And Daniel was the only prophet that was given these great visions of God that was repeated in the book of Revelation. Makikita po natin yung parallelism yan pagdating ng pag-aaral natin. And said, so he said, do you know why I have come to you? Sabi doon ng man of the vision, soon I will return to fight against the prince of Persia. Babalik na naman siya, makikipaglaban si Michael the Archangel. And when I go, the prince of Greece will come. Iba na naman, may prince of Persia, may prince of Greece. Sabi ko sa inyo, daming demonyo talaga eh. But I will tell you the truth. And that is what is written in the book of truth. No one supports me against them except Michael, your prince. And in the first year of Darius the Mede, I took my stand to support. And then makikita natin yan sa verse 11. Whew! Ang dami ng vision. Amen? Amen. So the Lord is saying, peace be upon us and be strong. Amen? Amen. Kailangan ko rin yun. Tayo lahat ay umuko at pumikit.
The peace that the world cannot give is the peace that the world cannot understand. It's the peace that the world cannot understand. Peace to know, peace to live. My strength I give unto you. My strength I give unto you. My strength. The world cannot give. It's the strength that the world cannot understand.
The world cannot understand.
unto you. My name I give unto you. It is the name that is above every name, the name of Jesus. Kaya kung ikaw ay naging struggle, if you have this great problem and worry in your life, the Lord has promised peace and strength and His name that you will need to overcome. There's no need for you to give up. There's no reason for you to give up. Cling on to the weapons that God has promised unto you in Ephesians chapter 6. Put on the shield of faith, the breastplate of righteousness, the gospel of peace and salvation on your feet, the sword of faith and the helmet of salvation. And the Lord is saying, my son, you are highly esteemed. You are highly favored. My presence is with you. My power is with you. My anointing is with you. My word is with you. Receive all the benefits of the cross of Calvary. And realize this, that in all the struggles that you will go through, in the war that you are about to be in, I will protect you. I will be with you. I will strengthen you. I will give you victory. If you are struggling right now and you don't have peace of mind and you are faint and weak because you feel that you are being persecuted, you go through a lot of struggles and pain and battles, the Lord is saying, my son, my daughter, I have come to restore you. I have come to give you peace. I have come to give you strength. I have come to give you victory. And so do not give up. Be of good heart. Cheer yourself up. For I, the Lord, will be with you. Pwede po bang lahat tayo ay tumayo? At sa oras na to, kung ikaw ay may pangangailangan sa Diyos, alam mo ba na hindi mo pa pinupuka ang bibig ko? Sa pagpukaba lang ng bibig ko, narinig ka na ng Diyos. The moment you opened your mouth in prayer, God heard you. God loves you. And God is very willing to answer your prayers. But sometimes, the Prince of Persia is trying to stop God's answers to your prayer. And so the Lord is saying, do not give up. For 21 days, Daniel wrestled and put himself in warfare, in the warpath of the devil. And in the end, Michael the archangel came to rescue him. Michael the archangel came to fight for him. And in the end, the will of God, the vision of God, the prophecies of God came. And so it's with you. Do not give up. Battle it out in prayer. Be strong. And fight it out with the devil and his demon cohorts. Because you have the name that is above every name. The name that is above, that is the name of Jesus. Meron ka bang panalangin sa Diyos? Sinagot na ng Diyos yan. At ibinibigay na niya ngayon ang kanyang kanyang katugunan. At kung pa ikaw ay naiinip at palagay mo hindi pa dumarating, patuloy kang makipagdigma. Patuloy kang makipaglaban. Kasama ba ang Panginoon? Magpakalakas ka! Huwag kang bibitaw! Huwag kang susuko! Tanggapin mo ang kalakasan ng Panginoon! Tanggapin mo ang kapayapaan ng Panginoon! Tanggapin mo ang pangalan ng Panginoon! At ang katagumpayan ng Panginoon sa iyong buhay! The name that is above every name, Jesus! Hallelujah! Kapatid, sabi nga natin kanina, nasa digmaan tayo. At sa oras na to, kung sa palagay mo, parating na eh. Parating na yung panalangin mo eh. Jesus, the name that is above every name, the name that is called the name of Jesus, is exalted far above the earth. His majesty and honor and praise. Yes. No other name but the name of Jesus. Yes, declare it. That the name of Jesus.
Yes.
prayer. Receive, receive. Stop me, devil! sa buhay mo. Ang pangalan ni Jesus ang nagpalaya sa iyo. Kagaya ng ating idineklara, walang makakapigil sa kalooban ng Diyos sa buhay mo, sa plano ng Diyos sa buhay mo. Ano pa lang mangyari, maganap, gagawin mo ang kalooban ng Diyos. You will not be distracted. You will not be slowed down. But you will fulfill the will of God. And you will finish the will of God in your life. No matter what happens. No matter what the devil says to you. Be assured in the presence of God, in the promise of God, that you have His name, Jesus. The name that is above every name. And so this day, I seal every deliverance that took place. I seal every victory that was received. I seal every healing that happened in this place. And I seal every answers to prayers and declaration that we have declared upon this place. Whatever it is, come on, seal it with the blood of the Lamb. Seal it with the blood of Jesus. And walk in this truth day by day in your life until the second coming of the Lord Jesus. Walk in victory. Walk in the awareness that Jesus is upon you and with you and will forever be with you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Maraming maraming salamat, Ama. Maraming maraming salamat. Puro ba siya? Isang ahong palakpak para sa ating Panginoon. Tayo po natin, makakaupo.
Gusto ko pong pasalamatan ng Lord dahil unang-una sa lahat, nandito po ako. Amen po ba? Kasi po, bilang college student, sobrang busy po at sobrang naburden po ako pag hindi ako nakaka-attend. Kasi po, ang daming requirements, ganyan. Tapos dapat po hindi po ako makaka-attend ngayon. Pero sabi ko, Lord, ayoko na ma-miss yung church. Amen po ba? Tapos nakakatuwa po kasi gumalaw yung Lord. Tapos, natanggal lahat nung dapat kong gagawin ngayon for my school at nandito po ako at nag-exhort. Amen po ba? Amen. Yun po, yung mga ganung bagay, kahit para po sa iba maliit siya, pero makikita niyo po yung galaw ng Lord na tunay nga pong napakabuti niya. Ganun din po, papasalamat ko kay Lord kasi ngayon po, dahil dun nga po sa pinapasokan ko sa UST po, nakakatuwa kasi po, nakikita ko din na yung Lord gumagalaw talaga sa buhay ko. Amen po ba? Ang dami po niyang binibigay sa akin ng mga projects. Kumbaga makikita mo po na may yung Lord ini-entrust niya sa akin yung mga projects na pang buong university. Amen po ba? Kumbaga pwedeng gawin ng iba pero sa akin binigay at tunay nga na ang Lord tinataas niya ako doon sa aking pinapasukan. At the same time, natataas ko ang pangalan niya. So
ako po ay nagpapasalamat sa Lord kasi patuloy na nagiging mabuti sa buhay ko. Kasi po, pinili ko po na pagtingkulan ng Lord bagamat may mga humahadlang na pamilya. Hindi po ako nagpadaig. Mas tinignan ko yung magagawa ni Lord sa buhay ko at saka lang ko hihipuin ng Lord yung pamilya ko. Kaya sabi ko, bahala na kung itakwil man ako ng pamilya ko basta ako magpapatuloy sa paglilingkod para sa Panginoon. Kaya nagpapasalamat po ako sa Lord. Ngayon po, tumitigil na sila. Kinakamusta na nila ako na mag-ingat daw ako palagi. Kaya yun po, sobrang thank you po sa Lord.
So katulad po ni Kuya Josh, nagpapasalamat din ako kasi po, naka-attend po ako ngayong Sunday. Kasi po, ngayon po sa, although siya kasi college siya, ako grade 11 pa rin, pero masasabi ko na sobrang stressed out po ako this past 2 weeks at sa susunod pa na week. Kasi po, last, hindi nga po ako naka-practice kaaban, so nakaka, medyo na, hindi po, nababurden din po ako na, kasi may mga priorities na kailangan prioritize. So, ngayon, nagpapasalamat ako kay Lord kasi although marami akong ginagawa, ganun, hindi pa rin, hindi niya ako pinapabayaan na, kasi nasasabi ko na never pa ako na-stress ng ganito kasi meron pa kaming dalawang defense this week, tapos meron pang, tapos yung upcoming exams, ganun. Pero, yan, thankful ako kasi never niya akong pinabayaan na although stress ako, ano, parang ano pa rin yung joy tuwing nakakapagbasa ako ng Word of ng Bible, ng Word of God. Parang nagbibigay encouragement sa akin na sa ngayon lang yan, ganyan, ganyan. Tsaka, so yun pa.
Ayun. Katulad po ng kila Joshua, siya kay Daphne. Ano din po, sa school din namin. Kasi this past few weeks din, sobra pong nagiging stressful yung mga school works. Nagsasabay-sabay po kahit anim lang po yung subjects namin. Tapos, ayun po. Yung stress, hindi lang siya na, ano, hindi lang siya sa mental health namin nakaka-apekto. Pati sobra-sobra po sa physical health namin. Katulad po ngayon, sobrang, ano po, paus po ako kasi, ano po, inuubo na ako. Tsaka yung mga kaklase ko po, ano, ano na po kami, mga zombie mode na kami. Sobrang itim po ng mata namin. Ay, ng paligid ng mata namin. Tapos nagsisiduguan na po yung mga ilong namin. Literally po. Kasi sobrang hirap po talaga ng, ano, ng setup namin ngayon sa, ano, sa, ngayong college po. Sobrang hirap. Akala ko na equipped na ako sa dati kong school, sa nung high school. Kasi po, galing din ako ng, ano, engineering and science curriculum. Tapos doon po, wala rin kaming tulog. Pero ngayon pong college, hindi ko na-expect na, ano, magle-level up yung stress. Tapos, hindi na po talaga kami natutulog. Mga 2 hours na lang yung tulog namin. Pero ano po, despite po yung lahat, kasi po meron din ako classmates na ano, Christians, meron ding mga Catholic, pero pusong Kristiyano. Tapos yun, ang nagiging ano po namin, ang nagiging sandigan namin, yung ano, yung mga Bible verses po na binibigay ng isa't isa. Parang, kasi po last time nag-overnight kami, tapos sobrang pagod na talaga kami. Parang wala namang ano, wala namang nakakapagpaiyak, pero naiiyak na lang talaga kami. Tapos biglang magtatawanan. Parang po kami mga baliw. Tapos nag-ano po, ginawa po namin, nag-search kami ng ano, ng Bible verses when ano, pero when stressed, gano'n. Tapos yun, nag-sharean kami na ganito, ganyan. Tapos doon po kami nakahanap ng ano, nakahanap ng physical at saka mental strength para ipagpatuloy yung week na yun. Tapos ano din, yun po yung naging threat namin, yung mga yung Word of God na sinashare namin sa isa't isa. Kaya nagpapasalamat po ako kasi last week at saka ngayong week, ay ngayong last Sunday at saka ngayong Sunday, nakapag church ako kahit na sobrang wala na, wala talaga akong ano, wala talaga akong time. Kaya, thank you.
Only you provide, 'cause you know. Praise God. Bago po tayo makapagbigay, meron po akong babasahin sa inyo dito po sa Aklat ng Unang Hari, chapter 17, verse 12. Sabi po dito, sumagot ang babae, alam po ni Yahweh na iyong Diyos na wala na kaming tinapay. Mayroon pa kaming kaunting harina at kapatak na langis. Naumulot nga ako ng maigagatong upang ilutuin iyon at makakain man lamang kami ng anak ko bago kami mamatay. Ito po yung babaeng balo na may isa pong anak. At siya po ay, sa panahon na yon, ito po si Propeta Elias, ay lumapit po sa babaeng balo na ito at hinamon siya na siya po ay magbigay. Ano po yung ibibigay niya? Yung meron po siya that time. Ano pong meron siya? Yung po ay ang kaunting harina at kapatak na langis. Alam niyo po ba kung gano'ng kadaming kapatak? Kapatak. At yun, mauubos na lang yon. At kaunting harina. Alam niyo po, ang madiin doon yung huli. Sabi niya doon bago man lamang kami mamatay. Isipin niyo, kung kayo yung babaeng balo at na may isang anak, bago daw mamatay. Pero hinamon siya ng lingkod ng Diyos sa mabuhay ni Elias, na inutusan din si Elias na ibigay daw po yun. At sumagot po si Elias. Sabi po ni Elias, huwag kang magalala, humayo ka at gawin mo ang iyong sinabi. Ngunit ipagluto mo muna ako ng isang munting tinapay at pagkatapos magluto ka ng para sa inyo. Alam niyo po mga kapatid, ginawa po yun ng babaeng balo. Sinunod lang po niya, inobey lang po niya yung salita ng Diyos, yung hamon ng lingkod ng Diyos. Alam niyo po anong nangyari? Naubos po ba yung gapatak na langis? At yung harina na yon? Hindi po. Alam niyo po, sa panahon na yon, inutusan ni Elias na 3.5 years na wag umulan. Natuyo ang batis. Kaya nga po, nagutong that time na yun kasi may dumating na salot. Pero, yung babaeng balo na yon, tumugon siya, alam yung nangyari sa kanya, blessing. Dito po sa verse 14. Sapagkat ganito ang sinabi ni Yahweh, Diyos ng Israel, hindi ninyo mauubos ang harina sa lalagyan at hindi rin matutuyo yaong langis sa tapayan hanggang hindi sumapit ang talagang takdang araw na ang ulay marapating papatakin ng may kapal. Ibig sabihin, sa loob ng 3.5 years bago sumapit yung pag-ulan, kasi 3.5 years na walang ulan. Bilhin nyo mga kapatid, kakain sila ng isang kainan na lang, mauubos na daw at mamamatay na sila. Pero nung tinugon ng babaeng balo, nagbigay siya, at ano yung nangyari? Sa loob ng 3.5 years, doon lamang mauubos ang kapatak na langis at harina. Kayo po, sa buhay po natin, sa inyong pong buhay, marami masabi niya, nagbigay na ako kanina. Pero yung babaeng balo anong meron siya? Konting harina at kapatak. Ngayon po, wala pong amount kung gano'ng kalaki ibibigay nyo. Tayo po yung mga babaeng balo sa oras na ito. Pwede nyo pong ibigay ang meron kayo ngayon sa oras na ito. Alam nyo po, mahimala ang nangyari sa isang kabataan. Kasama natin yung dito ngayon nasa province. Attendi po natin yung sa kasunduhan. Doon po yung anniversary ng radio. Sabi niya, di ba, laging pong ginagawa rin, nag-iikot ng offering ilang beses. Sabi niya, tuwing ikot ng offering, bakit? Ay, talaga nagbibigay siya. Ngayon, yung pangatlong ikot, pamasahin na lang meron siya. Tapos, sabi niya, Lord, gusto pang magbigay, kaso pamasahin na lang to. Kaso naiiya siyang ibigay, kasi ang pamasahin niya, magkano ba yung pamasahin dito hanggang kasunduhan? 16. Oh, 16 na lang ang pamasahin niya. Alam niyo po ba ang ginawa niya? Binigay niya yon. Tapos, nung binigay niya yon, sabi niya, Lord, gusto ko marami sana eh. Pero alam niyo ba, yung sope na hawak niya, nilapat niya sa bibig niya. Tapos, nag-pray siguro siya noon. Tapos nakita daw niya, may lamang pera. Dinagdag na lang niya yung barya niyang huling ibibigay niya. Ibig sabihin, nag-obey po siya. At deserve ng heart niyang makapagbigay. Sa buhay natin, mangyayari po yun. Ngayon po, hindi po natin isipin kung anong meron kayo dyan. Basta kung anong meron kayo dyan, ibigay niyo po sa Panginoon sa oras na ito. Sige po, tayo po'y magkaloob sa ating Panginoon.
peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God. Everybody sing righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's the kingdom of God. Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom? Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom? Don't you want to be a part of the kingdom? Come on, everybody. Don't you wanna be a part of the kingdom? Don't you wanna be?